Hi, I'm Barend from Tameson, and today we're going to discuss the main parts of a two-way solenoid valve. A solenoid valve is an electromagnetically operated valve that allows you to autonomously and remotely control the solenoid valve within a system. The different parts of a solenoid valve work together to ensure for optimal operation of your valve. You need to take proper care to ensure the parts are installed correctly, as missing or incorrectly installed components can cause the valve to malfunction. So what's inside a two-way solenoid valve? Let's find that out. First, let us look at the ports. The inlet port is where the media enters the solenoid valve, typically from a connected pipe or hose. Since it's a two-way valve, the other port is the outlet port. The regulated flow flows out of the valve through the outlet port. Important note on the ports, they cannot operate in reverse. There is typically an arrow on the valve housing showing the media flow path. The orifice connects the inlet and the outlet ports. This is an opening in the valve which is opened and closed by a plunger. The control of this opening is what allows the solenoid valve to regulate the media, allowing it to flow or not to flow from the inlet to the outlet. Next, we have the solenoid valve coil. The solenoid coil consists of several turns of enameled wire taking a cylindrical shape and a hollow from the inside. It connects to a power source, typically through a connector. When current flows through the coil, a corresponding magnetic field is produced. The magnetic field controls the position of the next component, the plunger. The plunger or piston is usually cylindrical in shape and made of ferromagnetic material suited within the hollow space inside the solenoid coil. It moves up and down to close or open the valve orifice. The field produced by the solenoid valve moves the plunger either up or down. And another component, a spring, moves in the opposite direction. For a normally closed valve, when there is no power, the spring is pushing the plunger down to close the orifice. When power is applied, the electromagnetic force overcomes the spring force, pulling the plunger up and opening the orifice, and allowing the media to flow through the inlet to the outlet. For a normally open valve, when there is no power, the spring is pulling the plunger up, and the orifice is allowing the media to flow from the inlet to the outlet. When the power is applied, the magnetic force forces the plunger to close the orifice. Guiding the piston is an armature tube, which is a hollow component that ensures the plunger is in the proper position. Any flaws in the tube can restrict the motion of the plunger. To properly close the orifice, there is a seal on the bottom of the plunger. Always ensure that the material of the seal is compatible with the media as the seal comes in contact with your media. Also, keep it free from dirt to prevent any clogging of the orifice. For AC solenoid valves, shading rings are located above the plunger to prevent any vibration and humming noises. And finally, we have the valve body. The solenoid valve assembly is connected to the valve body. The solenoid valve body comes into contact with the media. It's important to ensure it's compatible with it. If you suspect an issue with your solenoid valve part, a revision set or a coil can be purchased to replace the damaging part of your solenoid valve. For example, if your coil is burned out, you can simply replace one component instead of the whole valve. If you would like more information on solenoid valve parts, take a look at our Tameson's Technical Information Center. Also, check out our other videos on the workings of various types of solenoid valves and how they work. If you found this a useful video, please give it a like and subscribe for more videos. If you have any questions on solenoid valve parts or any other product, please contact me or anyone else at Tameson.